I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. I travel, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere. I've been to Reno, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Winslow, Sarasota, Wichita, Tulsa, Ottawa, Oklahoma, Tampa, Panama, Mattawa, La Paloma, Bangor, Baltimore, Salvador, Amarillo, Tocopilla, Barranquilla, and Padilla. I'm a killer. I've been everywhere, man.
I like to do photography and, you know, a variety of artsy kind of things.
Basically do a lot of kayaking.
I work in social service type stuff too, nonprofit work.
I like to play music and listen to music and drink.
I tend to go out to dive bars. I really like going to a cheap, dark, smoky setting and shooting pool and drinking beer and just have a good time. I don't really like the really hip, trendy places. Don't like the dancing.
Hang out with friends, go out, you know, like do some drinking, shoot some pool, and meeting the women, that kind of thing.
I think there's a segment that, in my case, and a lot of the people that I pal around with playing golf, and they just enjoy the Pabst type of a beer.
I drink Pabst. I like the taste of it, and it's priced right.
Springfield, Bakersfield, Shreveport, Hackensack, Cadillac, Fond du Lac, Davenport, Idaho, Jellicoe, Argentina, Diamantina, Pasadena, Catalina, Sea, Guadalina.
The reason people like our age like Pabst is because Pabst was your grandpa's beer. Budweiser or Coors was your dad's beer. You don't want to do anything that your dad does. That wouldn't be cool.
So they drink. I've always been a big fan of it, and it's always been cheap, it's always been really good.
I just like a beer that I know I'm going to like it when I drink it. Mm-hmm. I don't want to experiment anymore.
I don't know what makes Budweiser and Coors Light so f***ing suck. You know, it's out there in your face constantly. Uh-huh. I don't f***ing care about somebody's wingman in a Coors commercial or
right.
Two f***ing, you know, a set of twins.
Yeah, right.
I care about that.
Right.
I drink Pabst because it tastes good. My grandparents drink it. It's the first beer I stole from my parents when I was 12 years old, you know? It's the only beer I've pretty much drank my whole life. I'm not going to change that for anybody.
I'm glad to see that since it came so popular, the prices didn't just go, you know, the roof like a lot of things.
You know, they don't have the posters with the scantily clad Coors Light girls. And don't get me wrong, I love those girls. It's great. But it makes it this sort of national stamp and this sort of huge enterprise run by giant corporations, and that kind of ruins it.
It's not like a snobby.
Well, you can't drink. You can't go to the bar.
Cosmopolitan type of drink where you're like drinking down your foo-foo, $6.25 a glass drink.
Beer is not supposed to taste like fruit. All right, I don't want to taste a peach when I drink my beer.
The Mexican beer, I mean, the kids drink that. But hell, half the time you get it, who knows how old it is, and you open it up, it smells like a skunk jumped in it.
I'll go to buy beer at a store, and I'm sitting there looking at my choices.
Yeah.
And people will tell me to buy Pabst. They'll be like, oh, dude, there's no choice, just buy Pabst, you know, it's the one.
I think it's kind of a cool, unique thing about it. It makes it the cult beer, because it's from behind the scenes, it's not the big name.
Coors Light would be the opposite of a Pabst crowd, and that's
right.
Like,
yeah.
I mean, if you brought you go to a party, you bring Coors Light versus Pabst, you're considered like a frat boy. You're totally a 12-year-old that hasn't realized that there's anything other than Budweiser and Coors Light.
Here's the twins that will never talk to me at a party.
Yeah.
Great.
Right.
It's just a good, honest lager, you know, with no pretense.
It's not forced on us. It's not,
you
know, you don't get this heavy pressure to drink it.
Your basic beer, it doesn't offend people by having an obnoxious ad campaign.
It's not so much about being seen and seeing people. It's more about just being with who you're with.
All these chicks would be like, oh, she's a cheap date. She likes Pabst, you know, and like, oh yeah, that would be true, but then I would drink like an excessive amount of Pabst, so it's, you know, it might not be so cheap.
This is the best beer that I've ever had, and I've drank all the beers, Heidelberg, all of them. You know, a lot of the places are closed up now.
If I made more money, I'd still probably drink Pabst because it's crisp.
PBR to me has always been something that, it was almost like a clubber. It's almost like, you know, not everybody gets it, but you don't want everybody to get it. You don't necessarily want everybody to like and ruin, you know, your little thing that you have going.
The logo, like on a jacket,
or something, you'll see the big embroidered. It's been the same for however long, forever, I guess. I'm assuming. I like that. I don't like that they change every couple years or. Hey, here we are.
I just always thought it was a quality product, and but right now it's a quality product for a real, actually a very reasonably priced. So it's kind of, you kind of get the best of both worlds, I think.
In the movie Blue Velvet, Dennis Hopper says, "Pabst Blue Ribbon, f*** Heineken."
What kind of beer do you like?
Heineken.
Heineken, f*** that. Pabst Blue Ribbon!
Raise your hand if you think you're stopping this crew. Raise your hand if you think that we're not talking to you. Raise your hand!
It's not flashy personality, it's not the big bling blinger.
Crack a cold Pabst. I mean, nobody, you get almost laughed at if you have anything like Budweiser or anything. People are like, what are you doing?
And if you're really not in the mood, raise your hand.
You know, people like to think they drink it because they want to drink it, not because people tell them they need to drink it to be cool.
Just kicking it in like a, you know, like a dive bar, you know? Which is, that's what it's all about, you know? It's not like about trying to impress anybody else or trying to go off. It's still like a part of our lives.
It's an honest product, I think. It's not overly inflated. You don't see that PBR logo everywhere you turn on the TV. It's just a good, solid beer.
Dario Hayes into the past, a colonial maze where there's no more.
I don't get all the hype like I do from, like, Budweiser with their King of Beers crap. And the other guys, whoever it is, says champagne a beer. No, no.
If you want to buy something, you know, you buy what you want. That's the way I see it.
It's just like, we're beer, we're cheap, buy us. It's good, period.
One thing I've noticed is that you can always look for the PBR sign like in the window and you're like, oh, that's a cool dive bar. That's a typical thing around here. Every get-together seems to have the washing machine filled with the PBR, and you can rely on that.
Yeah, I think I love you, but what am I so afraid of? I'm afraid that I'm not sure of, but love there is no cure.
I could have filled a whole amount of all the Pabst cans that I had to recycle last year. I could have totally built a house. That was really enough.
What do you have? Cool Chris flavor. What do you have? Cool Chris flavor. What do you have? Cool Chris flavor. Pabst Blue Ribbon.
That's it, man.
The Pabst Blue Ribbon brand has been a stellar performer for the Pabst Brewing Company all year, and hopefully for your operation as well. Sales momentum has gained each and every month throughout the year, and this month is going to be our best ever. Hello, my name is David Mahoney, and I'm Vice President of Sales of the Pabst Brewing Company. The video that you're about to see has been put together by our marketing partners, not only as a sales tool for you and your operation, but as a visual statement as to what is going on with the Pabst Blue Ribbon brand throughout the country. I encourage you to take the time to watch the video with your sales and your management teams. Learn from this video. We think it's outstanding, and we think it can help you sell more Pabst Blue Ribbon beer. I thank you in advance for your time and attention to the brand, and hey, what'll you have? Pabst Blue Ribbon.
When it's time to party, we will party hard.
We'll be right back.
drink it out of the bottle, right?
Ah, drink it out of the sewer. Get it?
There hasn't been a day when we haven't carried PBR, and if you don't carry PBR, it's because it was all drunk before you got here.
Ain't nothing like a pack.
I find myself in a PBR as it's a full-blooded beer. And it's too expensive.
Music seems to be a great vehicle for to take Pabst to retail and to our target consumer.
We're Kiss Me I'm Sick, buy a CD if you've never heard us. I'd like to thank Pabst for sponsoring me for these last few months. We're gonna play one more song and bring up Reverser here.
Beer to drink, so I decided to get Pabst involved, and that means Pabst and the Onion are very, very much helping out the local music scene here, which is great, because Miller, who's supposed to be from here, he won't do it. New Rock 102, they won't do it. Laser 103, they won't do it. Pabst is supporting local talent. That's what's beautiful.
Starting to get into Pabst again. We're getting the new clientele, the kind of alternative people, and also some people who never drank Pabst before, a few white collar lawyers, doctors, they'll sit around and drink a 16-ounce can of Pabst, just like everybody, you know, the younger surfboarders or bike messages. So it's very good for
them. Down here in the South, there's a huge, huge respect for Pabst the Ribbon. There's a new generation drinking Pabst the Ribbon right now, and it's a lot of people. It's the rockabilly and punk rockers. You've got the alternative crowd, which goes a long way. There's a lot of young people that have a lot of respect for Pabst being an old-school beer. And the bottom line is, never, ever, ever heard anybody say, I don't like Pabst. Every single event that I've done, people love it. People are excited to see PBR in the market, and they just ask where I've been and when I'm coming back.
The grassroots program is working beautifully. From distributors, the word of mouth, to the whole state of Chicago buzzing with articles in all the local newspapers at least once a month.
Last month alone, I was up 237%. I expect the same every month in 2004. Bar owners love it because they can get a good deal on it and, you know, make some cash off it.
Bar owners tend to have a tight-knit community group, and it's all word of mouth, and they know how profitable PBR is.
There is absolutely nothing like PBR out there right now. It is far and away the hottest brand semester. In the 48 months that I've been around, I don't think I've ever had a month where I did less than 15% growth.
Pabst has been a very hot commodity in the Atlanta market. I think it has a lot to do with the whole retro movement that's going on, and the Pabst can has totally been reborn, and our sales are really through the roof.
Our draft business to year to date is up 300%, which is amazing. So it started from draft, and then we were able to build confidence with our sales reps from the draft success to go to the off-premise and start building more displays. We figured out that there is more of a younger drinker out there now that we're able to get that really wants to have Pabst. And we're marketing towards those people. And it's exciting because people are talking about Pabst. They're talking about it from the different articles that are being published out there. They're aware that we're using those types of information to sell in Pabst and say, hey, not only is it happening in Columbus, but there is a great awareness of Pabst that is coming across the country.